President Trump announced that the U.S., quote, essentially has the vaccine, and we will be announcing it very soon. To discuss that with us is Dr. Helen Boucher, chief of the Division of Geographic Medicine and Infectious Disease at Tufts Medical Center. Good to see you.
Good to see you, Emily.
So he also promised that every American who wants a vaccine will be able to get one by April. This timeline, it seems to change every day. What do you think is realistic?
Well, Emily, as we've discussed before, I think there still are several important steps for the vaccines to go through to get full FDA approval. And it's very important that they go through those steps. And they include public vetting of the data by experts at an advisory committee and at the CDC. So I think it's more likely that we won't see a vaccine available to everybody until well into 2021, perhaps next spring or summer.
Which mirrors what Dr. Redfield from the CDC told us, you know, just a few days ago. So let's stay with the CDC. The agency now saying people who do not have coronavirus symptoms, they should be tested for the virus if they've been in close contact with someone who has tested positive. That's a reversal from last month when they said no test if there are no symptoms. This is also confusing. What have you been telling your patients?
You know, it is a little confusing, and this whole, you know, evolution of treating this virus is still new and we're still learning, but it's very clear that people who are exposed to infected individuals should be tested even if they do not have symptoms. And that's what we've been telling people right along and what all the expert guidelines have been suggesting. So that's an important message because we know that many people don't have symptoms but can transmit the virus. So that asymptomatic or pre-symptomatic before the symptoms come period is an important time. And so if you've been exposed, very important to get tested.
All right. So the American Academy of Pediatrics announced today that it now wants student athletes who have recovered from COVID to have their hearts tested before they start playing sports again. What's the concern here?
Well, the concern here is that the COVID virus can affect the heart directly and cause what we call a myocarditis or an inflammation of the heart muscle. And so this is a recommendation to check, to have an extra check on the heart of student athletes. And it's recommended for student athletes anyway, but after COVID, I think this is a cautious recommendation in case there's been any effect, direct effect on the heart from the virus.
All right, so if we stick with sports for just a moment, it's a football weekend for local fans. BC is playing Duke tomorrow. College football season has been a bit controversial already at this point. Do you think it's possible to play contact sports without spreading the virus?
Well, you know, we don't know. I think there's a lot of hope that we can do it, and there are aggressive campaigns being run to minimize the risk to the players. Frequent testing and lots of measures with hygiene and distance and masks and all those things are being done. Minimizing the crowds, of course, very important. But I do think it's yet to be seen whether this can be done safely.
And as you said earlier, it's all an evolution, right? What we're learning, it feels from day to day. All right, Dr. Boucher, thank you so much for your time. As always, really appreciate it.
Thank you.